Hello and welcome in this new Minute Squash. Today we will see how to easily identify the tests to replay according to their previous results. There are two ways to do it. First, if you have a premium license of Squash EM, you can activate the Campaign Wizard plugin in the project's configuration page. Here and select your campaign, click plugin, and here you have the possibility to activate or deactivate the Campaign Wizard. Here the green indicates the plugin is activated. When this action done, go back in your campaign workspace, select an iteration, and click here, Campaign Wizard. By default, the selected source iteration is the iteration from which the Campaign Wizard was launched. The list here contains all the campaign's iterations. Here are the types of criteria, which could be simple criteria, inspired by the most frequent cases of reuse, or advanced criteria by selecting the tests to reuse more precisely according to your needs. Let's begin with a simple criteria, click next, and here you have the possibility to keep directly the source iterations failed test, blocked test, or tests linked with issues or regression test cases. Of course, you can select or deselect each option before selecting next. But let's say that you want to custom the criteria of selection. Go back to the previous step and click Advanced Criteria. Click Next. And here, you just have to select criteria and simply drag and drop them in the center of the page. So here, let's say that we want untestable test cases, blocked test cases, and failed test cases from our iteration. And let's say with a weight which is very high or high. A selection is done, but I have also an issue criteria block here displayed if the SquashTM project is linked to a bug tracker. As our current SquashTM project is linked to a Jira bug tracker, we can select keep the tests associated with issues. Here, we are able to select test cases thanks to the criteria status priority and assign to of their linked bugs. This way, we can select, for instance, all the tests with an issue marked as result, fini in French. There is also an option to select issues from the last or all execution in our campaign. Click Next. Here, the test cases list appears depending on the criteria selected during the previous steps. You can refine this selection and unlink the test cases unwanted in the new iteration by clicking on the minus button here. At last, all you have to do is enter a name, a reference, and a description to add the new iteration in your campaign. You can view that the new iteration in the campaign's workspace has just been created. Another way to identify the test cases to replay is to use the search feature accessible here and make your search according to more basic criteria than with the campaign wizard. For example, we want to add the tests to an iteration to re-execute them because they had blocked, failed, or untestable execution status. So add a criterion, click status, and select all this status. Our test cases are displayed there. By selecting them all, you have the possibility to add them to a new execution plan by clicking on an existing iteration. You can add the selected test cases to an existing iteration's execution plan in the library, or add selected test cases to a new iteration's execution plan of the selected campaign. The new iteration will be named as explained here. So I select my campaign and add an iteration. When I go back in my campaign's workspace, my new iteration is displayed here, and I can change its name here. I hope this video gave you some tips to improve your testing process with Squash, and see you soon for a new one.